الو،
السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام يا شيخ، شو اخبارك؟ يهرمين شيخ روحي.
أهلا، ازيك عزيزي؟ How are you؟
جدا جدا ممتاز، نشكر الرب. شيخ روحي، everybody, we welcome you and people that are listening, and maybe you like to share things with us. What do you like to say, شيخ روحي؟ You're welcome.
How are you؟ بارك
I'm fine, I'm fine.
الله فيك
I'm
يا
fine.
عزيزي. أنا خرجت من اليوتيوب لأن الجهاز عندي يعني
مش مشكلة، no problem. So شيخ روحي،
تقيل شوية،
we are talking
فنزل.
about the heaven of Allah. We are talking about the heaven of Allah.
نعم.
And I see in front of me a hadith where the Prophet, he promised us women who they are so white to the point we will see the marrow of their bones. Why is that?
Yes. Thank you, Christian the Prince. Do you hear me?
I hear you.
I hear echo.
Maybe your YouTube is still open, so close YouTube.
Echo.
Or mute YouTube. I think your YouTube is still open. This is why you hear me twice, maybe.
ثواني أشوف، ثواني شوية. ثواني بس أشوف
ولا يهمك.
اليوتيوب كده. الصوت
Voice is good.
كده، الصوت كده.
Yes, voice is good.
Voice is good.
Yeah.
Thank you. As to the woman in the heaven, يعني that you don't imagine the unlimited ability of God Almighty. So he laws differ from the earthly laws that known to people in this world. This this physical body which man lives in this earth now will not, because he will have a new body differ from this body. So human cannot imagine how it will be with God on the hereafter. So God Almighty has infinite things that no human can conceive. But your problem is that you cannot imagine this unlimited ability. Maybe confine God in person and in a human body. This semi content that makes God's power unlimited. One can't imagine the hereafter.
But we can.
Whatsoever try to imagine.
My friend, we can, because your prophet, he described that even the bones of those women, he said they are going to be transparent. So you say to me, we cannot imagine. No, the prophet even described their bones. So no, we can imagine. The question is, why they are so beautiful to the point I can see the marrow of their bones? Do you think seeing women bones, marrow, inside the bones, which means you will see her kidney, you will see even the food in her belly, you will see everything inside her, and then that is supposedly beautiful?
Yes, what a problem.
What
is from
but this is ugly. This is not beautiful. Here we go. If we look at an x-ray, because now we can have this, we can look at any x-ray for any woman or any human being, and we will see something ugly. This is disgusting. This is not something beautiful.
In the hereafter, the body of this human change and differ in this body. But this metaphor this metaphor to understand the people in this age of the Prophet Muhammad.
What metaphor? He's speaking about the marrow of the bones. That now this is a metaphor. You switch this to the metaphor. Do you have any proof that this is a metaphor? This is not a metaphor. This is about physical women. You will sleep with her, have sex with her. Are you going to have sex with this woman, or this is something virtual?
Yes. Well, what's the problem? This.
Okay. So, the problem is why he is obsessed with the white color. They are so white to the point we can see the marrow of their bones. What if I like to be to have a black woman? What's wrong with the black woman? Why in heaven of Allah, all of them they are white like pearls, and they are so white to the point we see the marrow of their bones? What if I like a darker skin? What if I like an Asian woman? What's the problem? Why they have to be very white, and they are extremely white to the point we can see the marrow of their bones? Is that because Muhammad is an Arab man speaking to Arab men who like Arab white women?
No. It is that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam want to said to people that in the hereafter the woman was very beautiful. One cannot imagine the hereafter whatsoever. Try to imagine if you, if you describe the sexual pleasure felt by adult to 5 years old, can that child imagine it? No, he cannot imagine it. He describe it as well as man, because in the hereafter will be things which no eyes has seen, no ear has heard, no human heart has ever perceived. So when God speaks of paradise, is to us the likeness of the garden, the likeness promised to the righteous in the in it are rivers of pure water. Say it is the garden, and says they were only given a simulation of it. So it is the sexual and the heaven.
But you know, you see, I listened to you to the end, but you gave me no answer, because all what you are saying to me, well, Allah will give us something beauty, and this beauty is someone we will see the marrow of their bones, and this is ugly for sure. Now, you know, if we ask a Muslim what is a beauty, he will say to us about the heaven. He will say the heaven nobody can describe. Even the Quran says that. So if nobody can describe, so why the Quran saying we will be sitting in the couches facing each other? Even he described the color of the clothes we will be wearing, the wine we will drinking. He described everything. You say nobody can describe the heaven, but the heaven described in very, very clear details in the Quran. So why Muslim, they say to us, why my throne in heaven is going to be so big to the point it is 70 mile big, and why my tent is 60 mile or 70 mile? You know, one of the hadith, your prophet, he said that the bedroom of a Muslim is going to be from Yemen all the way to Syria. Is that true?
Where the hadith, my friend? Can you read the hadith, please?
Yeah, here we go. I will read it for you in Arabic, and then you can go and get us. Then I will show a translation. أدنى أهل الجنة الذي له 80,000 خادم واثنتان وسبعون زوجة وتنصب له قبة من لؤلؤ وزبرجد وياقوت كما بين الجابية إلى صنعاء. Go ahead. This is a bedroom more than 1,500 kilometers.
هذا الحديث, this hadith not in the hadith, this is in the tafsir, and this is
no my friend, you are talking to Christian Prince.
A weak hadith.
Okay, so it's a weak hadith. So what we would do now, so weak, who is weak here? The prophet is weak, the Muslims is weak, Islam is weak. And by the way, how it's weak, and it is in Jami' al-Tirmidhi. Jami' al-Tirmidhi is the book of Sahih.
So when I see in the Jami' al-Tirmidhi, I will research in.
Okay, let us show you something else. Forget about this one. Forget about this one. If we ask you about the promise of Allah to us in the heaven, that says in the Quran that each one of us will have little boys who will serve us. Those are the boys from who, where they are coming from.
It is created from God. This little boy, it is created from God. This is as a slave or a service to the righteous in the hereafter. God can create this boys. What's the problem in this?
So Allah create boys, little boys, just to be slaves for me?
Yes, why not? Why you limited your
is that fair? Do you like to be a little boy serving somebody in heaven? Is that fair? Why Allah will abuse little children just to make them serve Mr. Sheikh Ruhi? Do you like that? You don't feel guilty?
Maybe يعني حتى يعني يعطي رغبة الأولاد وحب الأولاد أن الشخص يعني like to see the boys so God.
So you like boys. You see, you Muslims, you like boys.
Not like to surface, not like to serve. This is what the Quran.
But don't you think this is sick? That you like boys to serve? What does that mean? You know, they are boys. What boys can do? Boys, they need somebody to serve them. They are boys.
Yes, what the Quran said. Sawani, what Quran said. Yatuf, lahza. لحظة أنا أقرأ لك الآية. يطوف عليهم ولدان مخلدون إذا رأيتهم حسبتهم لؤلؤا منثورا. يعني that إنه this boy is serve the righteous in the hereafter.
And what is the beauty about that?
سواني I read what the interpreter said in this this problem and so sorry
no problem.
يطوف عليهم ولدان مخلدون بأكواب بأكواب وأباريق. يعني هنا يقول الطبري buy glasses and serve the righteous.
And what is the beautiful about that? Well, you see, in the heaven, Ruhi, supposedly, if you wish to have a dish in front of you, it's going to be just basically say, you know, a bit, like in the name of Allah, correct? So why you need a servant? And you will not get dirty. You will not need a shower. Your clothes will never be dirty, will never be a ruin, they will never have a wrinkle. So why, what that boys will do?
This boys as a serf.
But what you will do, I mean, if there's nothing to do, I mean, what serve you and what? They will just bring a cup of wine to you, right? That's their duty, and you are having sex. So you are having sex with a lot of women, and there's little boy next to you in the bed holding cups of wine.
No. You must imagine the hereafter.
I know this is the hereafter. Imagine. Doesn't matter. Aren't you going to have sex in the hereafter, my friend? Yes or no?
as to this, I said what's the problem in this?
Okay, I'm saying to you, so you are saying there's no problem that there's 80,000 little boy around your bed and you are having sex with a lot of women, and those boys, each one of them is holding a cup of wine for you, and they are watching you having sex.
No. How are they watching you?
So what do you mean? No, they are around you. They are around you. They are your servant. There's no other servant. They are little boys, and they, you are having sex. Here we go. It says reclining in your throne, and with you there is women, huru'ain, in the throne, in the bed, and they are very white. And who is the one serving you when you are with your women? The boys. So the women there in the heaven of Allah, they are just to take off their panty, and the boys is just to serve you. Is that correct? Yeah.
You hear me?
Yeah, I hear you.
So one minute, I want to see the voice, the echo. I will solve the problem and return. 1 minute.
Okay.
Not the police.
No problem. This is the spirituality of Allah. 80,000 little boys, slavery, and what their duty is to serve this guy, the sheikh with long beard, wine. This is what he's saying to us, and he's saying, "What's the problem?" Child abuse. And the one we are talking with is Dr. Rohi. He is a sheikh. He have a PhD from the highest Islamic school in the world, Al-Azhar University. Yes, Sheikh.
Aziz, a question.
Yes.
How is my voice now?
Your voice is fine, no problem. We are waiting for you to talk.
So what's your...
My problem is, can't Allah make me happy without having those boys? So look what we have here. The heaven of Allah is nothing but like a Las Vegas casino, full of prostitutes, women I never met, I never saw, I never heard of. They do not know me, I don't know them. They don't even know their names. Those women, they are ready for me just for sex. In the top of that, there is a bedroom which is so huge, in the size of two countries, and there's thousands of women waiting for me. And those women, they are so white to the point we can see through the marrow of their bones. In the top of that, this God, he promised a child abuse for little children to be slaves for eternity. And you are telling me what's the problem?
So, can you read the first, please? Can you read the first?
Which verse you like me to read?
That speak about sex and the heaven.
Well, there is many of them. We can go to different chapter, like this one we spoke. You already read from. We can go to chapter 37. Let's go to chapter 37. because that one is more into details.
Let us see.
You will see here that you are going to have, and by the way, I don't know why your God, he kept repeating himself. I mean, he just said that in the other chapter. So what the point? I do not know.
Which verse, please, in chapter 37?
Chapter 37, you can go and read it from 43, 44. Is a repeat of chapter 56. Proving again that Muhammad
43?
Yeah, 43. Chapter 37. You can read from 43, 44. This is because this is when we start speaking about heaven. In 43, and then you will see
in Jannat al-Na'im, in the garden of bliss, in the garden of
right, and then the boys will serve them, right, and the boys will not bleed.
على سرر المتقابلين, على سرر المتقابلين.
Who is the one will not
in bleed? The thrones facing each other.
Who is the one will not bleed, the Muslims or the boys? Both of them, chapter 56, verse number 19, and chapter 37, verse number 47, both of them it says yenzifun. Yenzifun means bleed. Who is going to be not to be bleeding, the boys or the men?
The men, what now I translate. What's meaning of yanzifun?
Yeah,
in English. So,
well, you speak Arabic. Nazif mean bleeding. Is that correct? You speak Arabic. I speak Arabic. Yanzifun is a verb.
Yes, yes. It is. There is. There shall be not trouble in it. Nor shall they be exhausted therewith.
But it says
this
yenzifun.
Is the translation
yenzifun,
of this.
Forget about translation. This is all fabrication. You know that the word yenzifun mean bleeding. You know that. I know that. And you agree that the word yenzifun mean a bleeding. Who is going to be not to bleed? The men or the children?
The men.
Okay. So the men, they will not bleed from what?
أنا أقرأ للتفسير أقرأ لك التفسير ينزفون ثواني في قوله ثواني دير ثواني my friend
no problem
that I read into the تفسير ثواني please, which I didn't see in the phone.
It doesn't matter, it is chapter 56, verse number 19, or you can choose. Yeah, choose this one. It'll go this one. Chapter 56, verse 19.
Okay. لا يصدعون عنها ولا ينزفون. Okay. 56. لحظة. I open تفسير.
ولا ينزفون.
What's it in the phone?
Yeah, Sheikh. You are a Sheikh. You have a PhD. And are you serious? You do not know what yanzifun means? Make a sentence for me in Arabic.
I want to say.
Sheikh.
No.
Make a sentence for me in Arabic that somebody. I will make a sentence you translate. Huh? نزف مني
الدم. اوكي, أوكي. لا
وتنزفون
ينزفون يعني لا تذهب عقولهم ولا يعني تبيد اموالهم أوكي. ولا تهدم صحتهم لا تضيع
hold on so you are saying to me he is saying the word bleeding but he meant by that their brain will not bleed their health will not bleed what does that mean
this
why he chose this word
النزف هو النزف هو if you want to answer you in Arabic النزف ذات هو الضياع الذهاب لا ينزفون لا تضيع صحتهم لا يضيع منهم don't lost of anything in the hereafter as the world this world so what see is Ibn Kathir سواني أقرأ لك what Ibn Kathir said in this statement means that it doesn't change their sense of reasoning Allah's statement. This is what said in Ibn Kathir and said all
well Ibn Kathir another Ibn Kathir trying to cover a problem because isn't your prophet he says that Muslim when he go to heaven he will go to the bazaar to the mall and this mall have pictures and images of men and women for sex and if a man he like an image of a man he jump in it and he have sex with it did your prophet says that or no
where he said that ثواني اقرا لك ما قال ابن كثير meaning they will never get headache
I know what Ibn Kathir said
will never
Ibn Kathir is a big fabricator even he denied the story of al-gharaniq and you know the gharaniq it's exist in the Quran he denied what is even written in the Quran read with me carefully Muhammad says indeed in paradise there is a market in which there is no buying nor selling except for images of men and women so whenever a man he desire an image he enter it what you will do with the image Dr. Rohi after you enter the image Do you want me to read the hadith for you in Arabic?
Yes, for Arabic. Which book this hadith is there? This hadith.
We can find it in many book, whatever you wish. إِنَّ فِي الْجَنَّةِ لَسُوقًا مَا فِيهَا شِرَاءٌ وَلَا بَيْعَ إِلَّا الصُّورُ مِنَ الرِّجَالِ وَالنِّسَاءِ فَإِذَا اشْتَهَى الرَّجُلُ صُورَةً دَخَلَ فِيهَا. Translation: Indeed, in paradise there is a market. Which there is no buying nor selling except for images of men and women. So whenever a man desire an image, he enter it. What do you do when you enter the image of a man? What do you do exactly with this man?
Week, hadith. This is in Musnad Ahmad.
Anything we say.
And this is
anything
this
we week, say. It's embarrassing.
This week.
Anything we say, it's embarrassing. It's weak. Okay, but don't you know that weak is accepted, Sheikh? You are a Sheikh. You graduate from Al-Azhar. You know Al Hadith. Even weak Hadith is accepted. That's why it's called weak. Even if it's weak, because weak means it has a rank. It's not rejected. The Hadith there is Sahih.
No,
absolutely. What are you talking about? Weak Hadith is accepted. So Muslims in order, okay, hold on. When you say weak, does that mean it is bad, it's rejected, or it mean it is possibly true?
So
are you sure you are the one who have a PhD, not me? Come on, Sheikh. Weak hadith, is it possibly accepted, possibly to be true, or totally false?
This hadith, and if the hadith weak, we don't take from hadith al-aqidah, and our belief in this hadith, but in the
that's funny. You say only what you like, as you did what he said. He says we take only what we think is good, what we think it is good. So you are saying to me, you choose your cherry, whatever you like, you like. You don't like, you say, I'm going to reject it because this is embarrassing, right?
Sorry, my friend.
There's a sheikh, his name is Sheikh Hamza. I don't know if you know him. He said, those Muslims who say weak hadith, they have a weak argument. He said that. I can even play the video for you. Those Muslims who say weak hadith, they have a weak argument, because weak hadith did not flunk, it passed. I'm just quoting him exactly what he said.
Yes, weak hadith, this friend, we don't weak hadith our religion.
Well, is the Quran weak hadith? Is the Quran weak hadith? Sheikh, are you there? Hello. I lost you.
Do you hear me?
Is the Quran weak? Is the Quran weak hadith?
No.
Okay. You get the Quran. No, no. The Quran you recite today is the recitation of Hafs, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Isn't it Hafs accused by Muslim that he is a fraud and he's a liar, and his hadith is rejected? So how you refuse his hadith, but you accept his Quran? If he is a fraud.
No, no. Hadith.
Hafs was Hafs
accused. Who accused? Who accused Hafs?
Everybody.
Yeah. Yes.
Everybody. Are you sure?
How?
Okay, here we go. Dr. Rohi now, he is saying that he never heard that Hafs is a liar, and he is the Quran he have is coming from a liar. Let us read together. Here we go. I'm going to show you the reference in the screen. Al-Bukhari, At-Tarikh Al-Kabir, variant number 2, page number 363. And you speak Arabic. Hafs ibn Sulaiman al-Asadi, Abu Umar al-Qari, an Al-Qama, etc. An Asim, Tarakuh, wa huwa Hafs Abi Abu Dawood al-Kufi. Al-Bukhari, At-Tarikh Al-Saghir, variant number 2, 233. Hafs ibn Sulaiman, etc. said, and then he says, an Asim wa Al-Qama, etc. He said, Munkar al-Hadith. We continue. Then Al-Bukhari Al-Du'afa, page number 35, it says Taraku wa qala Ibn Hanbal qala Yahya akhbarani Shu'bah qala akhada minni Hafsun bin Sulayman kitaban falam yarudduhu wa kana ya'khudhu kutubun nas fayansakhuha. So he's accusing him that he's a fraud. He copied the book of people and he claimed that those his book. Let us continue. Al-Albani is da'if Sunan al-Tirmidhi. Imagine, look at this. Then they accuse Hafs that he fabricated a hadith about the fire about the fire from the mouth of the Prophet. Sunan Ibn Majah, hadith number 216, number 38, Mushkat al Masabih 2141, Da'if al Jami' al Saghir 5761, and all of those saying that he is a liar and he is a fabricator. Al Albani. Irwa'u al-Ghalil, variant number 1, page number 260. An Umar, hada huwa Hafs ibn Sulayman al-Qari' al-Kufi, wa huwa matruk al-Hadith. Can you translate to us what matruk al-Hadith? Matruk al-Hadith means that his Hadith is garbage, is that correct?
No, no, as to Hafs, what said Ibn al-Jawzi as كان ثبتا في القراءة واهيا في الحديث لأنه كان يتقن الحديث أو يتقن القرآن ويجوده.
Hold on. What do you mean he كان يتقن الحديث? Either you know the hadith or you do not know. So why he's lying? So he's lying. Read with me carefully. وقال الساجي عن أحمد بن محمد البغدادي عن ابن معين كان حفص أبو بكر ومن أعلم الناس بقراءة عاصم وكان حفص أقرأ من أبو بكر وكان كذابا. And he was a liar. So you are saying to me that his hadith is rejected because he is a liar, but you accept the Quran from a liar?
Not كذابا ليس على حفص.
No, حفص is the كذاب. No, حفص is the كذاب. وكان كذابا. He is saying كان حفص وأبو بكر من أعلم الناس بقراءة عاصم وكان حفص أقرأ من أبي بكر وكان كذابا. Come on, you speak Arabic. I mean,
yes.
Come on.
So who narrated this hadith?
As-Saji. We showed you Muslim.
Yes.
Muslim قال متروك. Yes. قال عنه متروك. قال البخاري تركوه. قال الجوزاني وقد فرغ منه الدهر. وقال ابن المديني ضعيف الحديث وتركته على عمد. عن أبي حاتم عن عبد الله عن أبيه متروك الحديث. البزاز. All of them they say that he's a liar. So you Muslims taking the Quran from a liar. Do you have the Quran of Hafs? Do you have a book?
Listen to me. Listen to me.
Rahi, do you have a book written by the hand of Hafs? It's called Quran. No.
Listen to me. اتهام ابن معين هذا الاتهام منقول narrated عن ابن عدي قال حدثنا أحمد ابن محمد البغدادي قال سمعت يحيى ابن معين يقول كان حفص بن سليمان وأبو بكر بن عياش من أعلم الناس بقراءة عاصم وكان حفص أقرأ من أبي بكر وكان أبو بكر صدوقا وكان حفص كذابا. Now if we look at this narrated from ابن معين هو ابن محرز أحمد ابن محمد البغدادي. Is this narrated ثقه؟ Is this أو هل this from disciple ابن معين وافقوا على هذا النقل؟ نجد أن الراوي عن ابن معين ابن محرز أحمد ابن البغدادي مجهول. لم يذكر هذا الشخص في كتب الجرح والتعديل ولم يذكره فيه لا جرحا ولا تعديلا فهو مجهول الحال.
البخاري أحمد بن حنبل صحيح مسلم النسائي كتاب الضعفاء حفص all of them they are saying not one person look how many name. وقال البخاري تركوه وقال مسلم متروه وقال النسائي ليس بالثقة ويكتب حديثه وقال في موضع آخر متروك الحديث وقال صالح ابن محمد لا يكتب حديثه وأحاديثه كلها مناكير وقال الساجي يحدث عن اتسترا وحديثه بواطيل قال أبو زرعة ضعيف الحديث قال أبي حاتم لا يكتب حديثه his hadith is a lie we don't even write it down كذاب قال ابن خراش كذاب متروك يضع الحديث he is a liar and his hadith is rejected and he fabricate hadith قال أبو أحمد الحاكم ذاهب الحديث قال يحيى بن سعيد عن شعبة أخذ مني حفص بن سليمان كتابا فلم يرده وكان يأخذ كتب الناس فينسخها so he is a fraud he take books of people and he write it down claim it for himself so I can quote for you all those references look how many it's endless ابن حبان all of them they are saying حفص بن سليمان كذاب he is a liar كان يقلب الأساني read with me carefully وقال اتسترا كان يقلب الأسانيد ويرفع المراسيل وكان يأخذ كتب الناس فينسخها ويرويها من غير سماع لنفسه. So how you say and let me ask you is this hadith is accepted by you? Read the hadith. من قرأ القرآن وحفظه أدخله الله الجنة وشفعه في عشرة من أهل بيته كلهم قد استوجبوا النار.
It is a hadith weak.
Why it's weak?
This weak hadith.
Why it's weak? Is that because it's Hafs saying the hadith?
No. To discuss what about Hafs, about you said about Hafs. Everyone who نقل تكذيب ابن معين لحفص وابن محرز المجهول الحال بينما الذين لم يذكروا التكذيب أكثر يعني كل من ترجم لحفص من أئمة الجرح والتعديل تطرقوا إلى ضعفه في الحديث وإمامته في القرآن، ولم يشر أحد منهم إلى اتهامه بالكذب. فهناك بين أهل الحديث بين الراوي المتروك وبين الراوي المتهم بالكذب، يعني الترك متعلق بضبط الراوي لكن الكذب متعلق بعدالة الراوي. يعني إذا الراوي إن كان ضابطا لحديثه،
all of those scholars who they are the top of Islam, they said he is rejected. Now I have a challenge for you. Can you show me one hadith which is written by Hafs is sahih? Just one, just for my education. I want to learn from you.
He is awake in hadith, but
not even one hadith. The
Quran,
the one who gave you the Quran, not even one hadith of his is. You are the one who said to me that weak hadith is rejected 5 minutes ago. Now you are saying to me that all the weak of Asim is a lie. So this guy, he could not bring one true hadith, just one, just for fun. Who is going to believe in this? So you are saying to me, I cannot find you one report from Asim which is not a lie. That's what you just said. I said to you, give me just one hadith. Asim, he said, it is not a lie. You said to me, no, all of them, they are a lie.
As to Hafs, what said of many scholars about Hafs?
He's a liar. All of them, they said that.
يعني للمثال مثلا وكيع ابن الجراح ماذا قال عنه وهو متوفى سنة 196 هجرية؟ قال مات قريبا من سنة 90 و100. قال وكيع كان ثقة. مثلا سعد ابن محمد ابن الحسن العوفي تلميذ حفص نقل الخطيب البغدادي عن مجاهد قال حدثنا محمد إلى آخره، كان لو رأيته قرت عينك به علما وفهما. الإمام أحمد بن حنبل، الإمام أحمد بن حنبل.
But your answer proved the opposite, because if we cannot find one صحيح حديث from Hafs, that means he's a liar. And you just said you cannot find one صحيح حديث from him, just one. I mean, isn't amazing? Like, imagine, Dr. Rohi, you live and you are now 60 years old. In the 60 years of your life, you could not remember one correct narration from your prophet which is true. All you remember the lies. Isn't it obvious that he is a fraud? Imagine you are 60 years old, and then I say to you, tell me one true story from the prophet. And all the story you tell me, it's a lie, it's rejected. So what do you mean that there is others, they say he's a good man? Let us keep going. Dr. Rohi, listen, we are talking about the heaven of Allah, and you said to us, in the heaven of Allah there's a drink. Muslims, they will not get a drunk as you claim, and women, they will be there having sex, and those women are created for the men. Are they created from a flesh like a human? Are they human, those women?
Yes, like a human. Sure, like God created women like a human. As how
is Allah going to have sex with them?
How? No, Allah, no, Allah, no. How? What you say? How Allah asking, who have sex with?
Chapter 21, verse number 17, doesn't say that if Allah. And let us read in Arabic, so we don't go with the game of the translation, which is all a lie. لو أردنا أن نتخذ لهوا لاتخذناه من لدنا إن كنا فاعلين. What the word لهو mean in Arabic? Allah speaking, saying if we want to take a partner, we will take it لهو, we will take a لهو from ourselves if we want to do that. What is the لهو?
اللهو هو الشيء الذي يضيع، يعني يجعل الإنسان يضيع العمل الجاد. اللهو هذا هو اللهو.
No,
هذا
is,
هو اللهو
is,
في اللغة العربية.
This is an average answer for somebody is not educated. You are a person who have a PhD in Islam from another university. How you come with such an answer? لهو in Arabic is women.
Never.
You want to challenge me, Dr. Roy? Do you want to challenge me?
Yes, where this?
Okay.
Can you give me a dictionary said that lahu
okay.
Women?
The thing is, you are saying to me never. Okay. Let us see. Can you see my page? Can you see my
No, no, I don't.
Okay.
All right. See, can you read it, please?
All right. We will see here. This is Kitab al-Itqan fi Ulum al-Quran. I'm sure you heard of the name of the book, correct?
Yes.
Okay. He says, Lahu is the women in the tongue of the people of Yemen.
No, I want a dictionary that said Lahu is the women in the
Quran. So now the tafsir, the books of tafsir are not accepted by Dr. Rohi. Is that what you are saying?
Yes, one of the interpreters said
what do you
this,
mean one? Which
but,
one? Which
one it is not true.
Not, which one? All of them they say
well,
the same.
It is not true. What, so now,
what do you mean not true? Do you know, okay, who is your favorite interpretation? Who is your favorite scholar?
One of now I want to read to you from Ibn Kathir what said about this ayah.
Okay, you want so it from Ibn Kathir? Are you sure? Okay, read for me from Ibn Kathir. No problem.
I searched the
because Ibn Kathir, my friend, agree with me, and you have no idea what you just did. Ibn Kathir, agree with me. I just told you all the scholars agree with me.
Okay.
Okay. Go ahead, read it.
Had we indeed to take a bus time, we could surely have taken it from us if we were going to do that. Ibn Najih said in narrating from Mujahid. So this is Ibn Kathir said, had we indeed to take a bus time.
And what the word
this
lahu?
Is the meaning
don't skip the word. What the word lahu in the book of Ibn Kathir? Is it mean, does it mean a woman?
Yes. And this
yes, but you said never. A second ago, Dr. Rohi, aren't you the one who said never? Now you said yes. So Ibn Kathir agree with me that the word lahu mean a woman.
You don't said, and I search and Ibn Kathir in Arabic.
Okay,
verse.
All right, then if you don't say that, let us see if he say that or not.
What he call?
Give me a second.
أن
give me a second.
لهوان,
I will put it for you.
لاتخذناه من لدنا إن كنا فاعلين. قال ابن نجيح عن مجاهد لو أردنا أن نتخذ لهوا لاتخذناه من لدنا يعني من عندنا يقول وما خلقنا الجنة ولا ولا موتا ولا بعثا ولا حسابا. قال
let me read for you تفسير ابن كثير. You are escaping the disaster. This is Ibn Kathir in the screen. Everybody can see it, including you. And I'm reading Ibn Kathir, a different book. قال مجاهد يعني من عندنا يقول وما خلقنا جنة ولا نارا ولا موتا ولا بعثا ولا حسابا. وقال الحسن وقتادة لو أردنا أن نتخذ لهوا اللهو المرأة بلسان أهل اليمن. This is Ibn Kathir, my friend. So what you are saying to me, it doesn't say that.
Yes, and Ibn Kathir also said, وقال عكرمة والسدي المراد بالله ها هنا الولد وهذا الذي قبله متلازمان هنا ماذا قال
وقول
لو أردنا أراد الله أن يتخذ ولد.
Oh, hold on. So you are saying to me, in the Arabic language, you said in the beginning, never, the word له mean women. And now you are saying, it mean ولد, correct? This is what it says. This is what you say. Okay. So it mean women, but you said to me never. But you said to me never. But you said never.
Yes, I said never in the dictionary. Can you
no,
search
my
in
friend,
the dictionary
even
as
dictionary,
you search?
Yeah, this is from the dictionary too. Because Ibn Kathir is getting it from where? From his pocket? Ibn Kathir, Al-Qurtubi, Al-Tabari, all of them, they are coming saying that Lahu is the word mean women. Now let me ask you. You said that it might mean, they are not sure, that some they say he want to take a woman, some they say he want to take a son. But the verse says there, he will take it from ourself. How, I asked you, are they those are human? You said yes. So how Allah will take partner from ourself, but that you are the human? If Allah consider those women ourself, that mean ourself, Allah is one of many other human. They are like him. He called them ourself, correct?
From Lahu and the dictionary, please. Can you search about
my friend, why you want
to word Lahu in okay. the dictionary?
All right. So you are saying now Ibn Kathir, he don't understand Arabic? Are you saying that? You are the one who chose Ibn Kathir, and now you don't want Ibn Kathir. Is that what you are saying?
Ibn Kathir narrated a lot, saying that he just narrated,
we know, but he is saying that in his book. And this is not only him, it shows different interpretation, and I will show you the same. So what will we do now?
There is another saying. What? Why you not take this? Now I open the dictionary. Okay. The dictionary online. A Muslim, you know this. A Muslim in the lahu. مثلاً lahu amusement, distraction, the diversion, entertainment.
Entertainment. Allah will take entertainment. Okay. Now listen, Sheikh. This is the dictionary. And this is Al-Mu'jam Al-Wasit. In the front of your
fun basi.
Okay. This is Qamus Al-Mu'jam Al-Wasit. Wa ma'na lahu Al-Mu'jam Al-Wasit. Al-Lisan Al-Arab. Al-Qamus Al-Muhit. Qamus Arabi Arabi. All the dictionary you wish to have. It says in the front of us, lahu al-mar'a al-malhuwa biha, a woman which you play by her, which means sex. It's in the front of you in the screen. Don't tell me now you do not know Arabic. And this is the dictionary you are asking me to show.
No, this in the dictionary is in front of me. Allahu ma ma la'ib ma la'ibta bihi wa shaghalaka min hawan wa tarab wa nahwihima.
True, but what is meant in the Quran, Allah will take it as a partner, so he cannot take party as a partner. So you have to find what he meant. He's talking, if you want to take a partner, are you saying lahu mean party and Allah will take a partner party? He will partner with Mr. Party. Is that a person? So Allah saying, if I want to take a partner, I will take a lahu. So lahu have to be a person, not a party, not just something fun, a person. And it says in the front of us in the dictionary, and this dictionary you choose, al-mara'a al-malhuwa biha. And Ibn Kathir, Al-Qurtubi, Al-Tabari, Al-Jalalain, all of them, they say the same. Let me open Al-Jalalain. I will put it in English in the front of everybody, so everybody will see that you are trying to escape the disaster. Allah is saying, if I want to have sex, I will have sex with women who they are like us, from us. So the Muslim, they claim that Allah is one and no one like Allah. And then we find that Allah, he have us, and he is going to have sex with the women of the heaven. And who is the one saying that? Is that Christian Prince interpretation? No. This is your interpretation, your scholars, and let me put it in the screen and I will make you, Dr. Rahi, if you don't mind, please, to read for us, and it's in English. I will show it in English. So everybody will see. Here we go. This is Tafsir al-Jalalain. And it is in the screen. Read for us, Dr. Rahi. I will give you the link. If you want, you can open the link in your browser. Here we go. I will send it to you in your in
Okay.
Here we go. Open it. It says, had we desire to find some diversion that which provide diversion in the way of a partner or a child, we would have found it with ourselves from among the beautiful eyed houris or angels. Do you see it?
I opened the when I opened the link.
No problem.
This the line?
Yes.
The, to find some diversion that which provides diversion in the way of partner or a child, we found it with ourselves from among the beautiful eyed hours or angel, are we to do so? But
so the lahu, is the huris. The lahu is the huris, correct? You are denying this all this time, and all the scholars, including Ibn Kathir, they are saying this is Jalalain. All of them in dictionary saying that the word lahu is women for sex. So Allah is saying if you want to have sex, you will have sex with the women from the heaven. How that is possible?
This is new al-Jannah.
What?
From other seer of مثلا تفسير تفهيم القرآن.
My friend, you know, Dr. Rahi, you are being funny now, with respect to you. Tafhim al-Quran, written by whom? A guy who is born yesterday, now he explained the Quran. Maybe you can make a book better than him. We are talking about the Jalalain. You quote for me Tafhim al-Quran. This book is written by who, Tafhim al-Quran?
Yes, but
by Mickey Mouse? So you are a person who has a PhD, and then you quote for me someone who says stupid things. He is not a scholar, and nobody even agree with him, just because you are trying to avoid the point. Ibn Kathir, Al-Jalalain, Al-Qurtubi, Al-Tabari, everybody saying that this is a woman, and those are, is Al-Jalalain a scholar or he's not?
But not all this Al-Jalalain, Al-Tabari, Ibn Kathir, not accepted on one, a few.
They accepted, my friend, here we go, this is Ibn Kathir. Ibn Kathir is quoting all the opinion. He is not rejecting any. He is just quoting for you. This guy, he said, it's meant this. This guy, he said, it's meant that. Al-Muradu huna billahu as-saddi al-walad. The other one, he says, no, it was the women. Al-Mar'a bilisani ahl al-Yaman. So he is quoting for you opinion. It's not Ibn Kathir explaining. And the same for Al-Jalalain. This is what it's meant. لو أردنا أن نتخذ لهوا ما يلهى به من زوجة. This is what Ibn Jalalain saying. Tafsir al-Tabari is the same. So you are trying to avoid the problem. Allah is saying he will take a partner, and this partner is a woman, and he called that woman ourself. If Allah is one, how he called women ourself? What ourself mean? Min ladunna, ourself. How those women became ourselves?
Yes.
Okay. Are those women from the kind of Allah? Maybe from his family or his tribe?
No. God want to see to us to people that he is not like a human. He need to anything as a human. So if he want to take anything to pastime, he don't need. People don't need a human. Don't need.
What do you mean? He don't
you
need
to help you.
He said. If we want, we will take this. He just told you he would that if he wish. This is. He's saying if I wish, I would do that. So he choose from who? He says I will take them from the Huri. So you cannot deny saying he will not because.
So he don't wish. He don't wish.
In kunna fa'ilin. He did not say I don't. He said in kunna fa'ilin, if we want to do that. However, it's an option. So if he want to do that, if want to do that, we will do it. We will take it from those women. Now, why he called those women ourselves? Regardless he wish or not, if I call those people ourselves, that means they are from my kind. You see, when I say ourselves, we are talking about us, maybe as a family, maybe as a tribe, like maybe two tribes are talking to each other. One of them, he says, ourselves, we don't agree with yourself. So when Allah says ourselves, speaking about taking a partner, he is not speaking about himself only. He's speaking about a group which is covered by an umbrella, which is ourselves. So in order for those women to be from considered from the ourselves, they have to be from the same kind of Allah.
What said the tafsir? فبين تبارك وتعالى كيف يفعل الله لو أراده ولا خلاف أنه تبارك وتعالى لا يريد ذلك ولا يفعله. فإذا هذا ما قاله المفسرون لا خلاف بين ذلك أنه لا يريد ذلك ولا يفعله.
The tafsir says too that Allah, if he want to have a sex, he will have it with the women. That's possible. Then it's about if he wish or not. So, and he called those women ourselves. So Allah is not what the Muslim they claim. He is a monotheist. He, the oneness of Allah, here we go. He called a group of females who they are made for sex. And I ask you, are they human? You say yes. Those are huri. How Allah saying it is possible if you want to take a partner, he will take her from a human. She is a huri made just for sex.
In this, in kunna fa'ilin, wama kunna fa'ilin. The meaning if in kunna fa'ilin, wama kunna fa'ilin. Huna ilga'a bima'na shart, yani taqdeer al-kalam, law kunna lattakhazna.
Okay, well, hold
law kunna lattakhazna.
Where it says wama kunna fa'ilin? Doesn't say that. Are you adding words?
Wama kunna fa'ilin, tafsir. Yes, do you want the tafsir?
Did you hear, guys, Dr. Ruh, he's adding words to the Quran. You are adding words to the Quran. Allah did not say, and we are not going to do that. He did not say,
Wama kunna fa'ilin. Not me.
Okay, so you are saying that the scholar, he added words to the Quran. Allah did not say, we will not do that. He says, In kunna fa'ilin. He did not say, Wama kunna fa'ilin.
This what said by Ibn Juraij.
My friend, I don't care what Ibn Juraij does. The Quran says we will not do so. No, it's a fabrication. So if you are saying Ibn Juraij says the verse saying ma kunna fa'ilin, that means there's other Quran different from this Quran. Do you agree with Ibn Juraij or with this Quran?
So in kunna ذلك لن يفعل هذا
my friend, in kunna, that's mean if it's if we will do that, we will do this, but doesn't say nowhere I will not do that. If I say to you, if I want to buy Pepsi Cola, I will stop in that supermarket. So I did not say I will not do that. I say if I want to buy, I will buy it from there, as simple as that. Nowhere it says I will not do it. However, the important, my friend, he do it or not, that's not important. The important is, he says we are going to take it from us. He's talking about taking the partner, and the partner is from us. And here we see that Allah and the human and you are sharing bed together. So you, Dr. Ruhi, and Allah, you will have some beautiful women made for sex, and you, both of you, will have a threesome maybe.
My friend, you must read the scholars, the saying of all scholar.
I just showed you the scars. Here we go. Jalali,
the next ayah, what said? بل نقذف بالحق على الباطل فيدمغه.
So what is that?
Allah Azza wa Jalla ليس عنده باطل.
What does have to do with my topic? You see, the Quran is a very funny book. He just said a verse after it, have nothing to do with the verse before it. We are talking about having children or having a wife from a having sex with a wife, and then we will have a son from her. So the verse after it have nothing to do with that. And this is the Quran. The Quran have nothing to do with each other, which is proving again that the Quran is not a book of God, because the verse after it should be connected to the verse before it, but there's no connection. The same as the verse before it. What the verse before it have to do with the verse after it? Nothing. What is the verse before it have to do with the verse after it? Nothing. This is the Quran. It's a book of talk, you know, a guy just keep talking, saying nothing, just to fill up the pages, making himself like he's speaking to God. And you know, Dr. Rouhi, I will give you a chance, we will change the topic for you. You choose for me, in the front of everybody, everybody is my witness. Choose for me one thing in this book, it's called Quran, proving Allah to be exist and he is God. Choose for me something not stupid in this book. I'm not being rude, you know me, I speak things as it is. Can you show me one chapter in this Quran? We cannot accuse it to be stupid.
No, no, choose
the most wise chapter in the Quran, and I will prove to you this book cannot be from God. Choose for me the best chapter you have. You have a PhD from the Al-Azhar University. You are a doctor. You are a sheikh, and I am listening. Give me the best chapter in the Quran, and everybody will laugh. This is cannot be the book of God. Choose it. Which one?
If I choose,
people will say he choose bad stuff, silly stuff. I want you to give me the hardest one. Which chapter in the Quran you think can make those Christians? We have almost 900 people listening. Can you make those Christians believe in Allah by giving us something from the Quran? Something very powerful.
The first chapter, Al-Fatiha. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.
All right.
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.
Okay, but this is not the first chapter in the Quran, you know that. This is not the first chapter. This is supposedly given to Muhammad later, but let us go together.
The first chapter in the Mus'haf.
This is in Mus'haf of who? Ibn Mas'ud? Ibn Mas'ud don't have Al-Fatiha. No problem. Now let us read together. In the name of Allah, the most Rahman al-Rahim. Why Allah is saying in the name of Allah if he is the one who is talking?
Because this book is the human and the, and
what the, what the human?
For
what
believers. Human? And when believer is,
who is the one who is
speak,
talking?
He said, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
But he is talking. Who is the one who is talking? If you are Ruhi, do you say to Christian Prince in the name of Ruhi? Does that make sense to you? Since when, if a person is talking, he say in the name of, I am a Christian Prince, I say in the name of Christian Prince?
Yes, this book is two people, not two.
I understand it's two
so
people.
When the,
so
when people
I understand it's two
reading
people.
This
book. So why Allah, he don't say, I am Allah speaking to you. Instead, he said, in the name of Allah, which means the one is talking cannot be Allah. There's no way the one is talking is Allah.
No,
he's saying the name of Allah.
It is not beautiful to say I am the God. So when
what's
we read this,
what's wrong? Isn't it Allah? He said, how come Allah, when he saw Moses in the Quran, he says to Moses, I am Allah Rabbul Alameen. So you just said it's not beautiful to say I am Allah. That's funny. This is against what the Quran teach. The Quran says that when Moses, he came to the tree which was burning, Allah, he said to Moses, and Allahu, he spoke from the tree, saying, I am Allah, the Lord of the two world. Is that correct? Did he say, I am Allah?
Yes, okay. God want to declare about his self to Moses in this, moment.
But you said, you said it's not beautiful for Allah to say I am Allah, but here we go. So Moses, he saw the fire in the tree. Allah said to him, verily I am Allah, the Lord of Al-Alameen, the two words which don't believe in the genie and the human. So why you said to me it's not beautiful for Allah to say I am Allah, the Lord of the two words?
So now if you want to read the Quran, do you said I am the Lord, the Lord of the world?
You should.
How do you see?
Because how people now will know, okay, when you say Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, all right, that's mean the one is talking is not Allah, it's someone else. That's mean the Quran is a fabricated book. This is the author of the Quran, the one who wrote the Quran. He is saying, he making a prayer, says, in the name of Allah, so if I am writing a book, I write, if I am a Muslim, in the name of Allah, etc. Because simply, I am making a presentation for my book, because I am an author, but not I'm not Allah. But if Allah is the one who is writing the book, He will not say in the name of Allah. He will say, I am Allah, the Lord of the world. And then look at the verse after. And supposedly you choose for me a smart verse. All praise be to Allah. How Allah say all praise be to Allah? Allah speaking, saying, all praise to Allah. Or this is a prayer made by a man praying to Allah.
Yes, this is the هذا هو أسلوب اللغة العربية وأسلوب العرب.
My friend, I am an Arab. I am an Arab more than you. You are not an Arab. You are an Egyptian. So don't tell me this is أسلوب اللغة العربية. All praise to Allah. If somebody praying to Allah, he say that to Allah. But Allah speaking about himself, saying all praise be to Allah, the Lord of man. He already says I am Allah. Why? And then he repeat again, verse number 3, the most beneficent, the most merciful. But he just said that. He just said that too. A second ago, why he's repeating it again? Because he's empty, there's nothing to say. And then the only honor and the ruling judge in the judgment day. Okay, nice to meet you. And then he says, you alone we worship. Allah saying to Allah, you alone we worship. Or this is a guy making a prayer.
Okay. And now when we said Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, this is how when we read this Quran for reading, but if this not for reading, we don't say that. Now in masalan في الصلاة الربانية لديكم أبانا الذي في السماوات ليتقدس اسمك ليأتي ملكوتك لتكن مشيئتك كما في السماء ذلك في الأرض إلى آخر الكلام إلى آخر الصلاة.
We just made Dr. Rohi Christian. He was reciting.
لأنها ليست قراءة. لأنها ليست قراءة.
My friend, no. There they ask Jesus, how you pray? He say you pray like this. Is that the same? No. You see in the Quran when Allah he said to Muhammad say he say قل. Did he say here قل? No. So he did not say. He did not say pray like this. It is just Allah talking. As long as Allah talking, that is impossible, because Allah is saying, you alone we worship and you alone we seek. Okay, how that can be if Allah is just talking? Otherwise, here there is something missing. And as you said, obviously Muhammad was trying to copy the prayer of the Messiah, which he taught the Christians, our Father art of heaven, forgive to us so we can forgive to others. Guide us to the straight way. So this is obviously a prayer written by Muhammad, fabricating the prayer of our Father out of heaven, claiming that it's Allah, but he forgot to switch from that first person to the second person in the name of Allah. So that is second person talking about who? About Allah. So the author of the book is the one who says in the name of Allah. The writer of the book, he says, we seek you, only you we worship. There's no way Allah says only you worship, because if Allah talking to me, then he should say pray like this to me. I am your God Allah. I am the only one who own this world. I am the only one who can help you. But to say you alone we worship and you alone we seek, that is silly. Don't you think so?
No, no, it is Quran. What meaning of Quran? Quran يعني شيء مقروء.
No, my
شيء
friend.
مقروء.
Let me teach you.
No,
Quran does not mean something مقروء. مقروء in Arabic, the way you mean it. The word قراءة is not even Arabic. It is Aramaic. From قرى وراء. قرى بلسانه وراء بعينه. He say with his lips and he saw with his eyes, which means he say with the lips what he saw in the eyes. So when you say this is a book of qira'ah, that's mean, and you are just saying that, that is mean reading. So how you can read something is not written yet? This was not written. So how you read it, but yet it's not written? And when Muhammad first time, the angel came to him, he said to him, read. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay, so how he read if he cannot see a book? Did he give him a book?
القراءة معناها أنك تقرأ تعيد الكلمات
okay,
ورائي كما أقولها
okay.
الآن
English please. English الآن please. Can hear. What قراءة
means okay.
English please.
قراءة means that you read what I say to you.
That means you repeat, correct?
No, now the blind, when he recites the Quran.
No.
We said he مقرئ, هو قارئ, هو okay. He is a reciter. Mm.
Reciter, thank you very much. But recite, thank you. My friend, the one who recites the Quran and is blind, he recites something he memorized. Muhammad, he did not have the Quran yet, so how he can recite something he did not memorize? So you said to me, Iqra, and a second ago, and I corrected you, and you are the one who said that Iqra means reading, correct?
Yes.
Okay. So Allah, he said to Muhammad, read. Did he say to him, read or recite?
Now, when the teacher said to the pupil, read, read this, اقرا ورائي, اقرا ما اقول لكم, اقرا ما اقول لكم.
My friend, I want
to ask,
is the word قرا mean recite, repeat after me, or mean read something written?
The bus, read something written.
Repeat after me. So why Muhammad said I cannot repeat by saying the word repeat again? He just repeated. He just said to him one word. He said to him, read, iqra. Muhammad, he says, I cannot iqra. So you are saying to me that Muhammad, he said the word, but yet he claimed he cannot say it? If the word iqra means repeat, repeated.
What he said, ma ana biqari, what you want me to read.
Thank
what
you very much.
You want me to read,
guys.
Ma ana biqari.
Thank you. So I do not know. Okay, so what I should read, correct? What I should read. Okay, so why the angel, he squeezed him again, says to him, read. He did not tell him what to read.
Yes. Because he don't read anything. He said,
well, he told him read what? Why the angel read, squeezing him again? The guy, he did squeeze Muhammad, and he says to him, read. Muhammad says, according to you, read what? The angel, he squeezed him again, and he said, read. The guy, Muhammad says, read what? The guy, angel, squeezed him again, and he said to him, read. Muhammad, for the third time, says, read what? So why the angel don't say to him what to read what? I mean, the guy keep asking you, why you keep squeezing him?
Okay, said then the angel said, اقرا باسم ربك الذي خلق. اقرا باسم ربك الذي خلق. خلق الانسان من علق. اقرا وربك الاكرم.
Why he did
وبدأ
not say
يعني okay, hold on. Angel you said, start you to, said, read, okay. to read what the
okay, you said to him, you said that he told him read, and he said what I will read, right? But the angel says to him, read in the name of your Lord. Read what? He did not tell him what to read. Read in the name of your Lord. Okay, read what? Read in the name of your Lord. Read what?
He wants a prophet to focus this, read this to his
my
saying
friend, focus
that he
on what?
Want,
the
want
guy
to
is
say.
Asking you, and you are the one who said that Muhammad was saying to the angel, read what? What I shall read. So now the guy said to him, read in the name of your Lord, but he did not tell him what to read yet. Where is the reading he gave him to read?
He wants him to focus.
Why Muhammad was not focusing? He was a drunk. He squeezed him three times, and still Muhammad saying, read what? I mean, Muhammad is right here. If somebody squeezing me, keep saying to me, read, and I will say to him, read what? And then he squeezed me again, and I said to him, read what? And then he screamed it
third
time.
And the fourth time he said
he did not tell him to read what. He said to him, Iqra, read. He continued saying reading, but he did not give him a book. Did he give him a book to read?
Yes, my friend. Now I want to go.
All right. Thank you, Dr. Rahi, for calling us. It was a pleasure to talking to you as usual.
شكرا أنا سعيد يعني بمناقشتك الله نتكلم في وقت آخر وسأراك وشكرا لك for your kindness
thank you take care my friend take care bye bye
take care.